Hi, in this tutorial, we'll go over a way to track hours worked in Excel. We'll also go over how to calculate pay in Excel for the hours worked. So we'll start by labeling the headers that we'll need. We'll need headings for date, start time, end time, breaks, total hours, pay rate, and total pay. Okay, so now that we have our headings, let's bold them and make sure that we can read them all. Now the date field, that's just going to be the day that you work. So I'm gonna do just a couple of days because we're just gonna illustrate how this works. So we'll do 1-8 and 1-9, 2018. Now the start time and end time is just when you started working and when you finished working. So I'm highlighting those cells, right clicking, and under format cells, I wanna format them as time. Now I find it easier to read start and end times with a PM, AM designation at the end. So these are great for that, or ones with military time, which is the ones that start with the 13 in front of them. So I'm going to choose this one. If you need to go to the seconds, these with the three numbers, that's what that means. So I'm going to click okay. And we'll say we started at 8 a.m. on the 8th, and I'm going to type a.m. at the end of it. And then on the 9th, we started at 9 a.m. And for the end time, we'll say we finished at 5 p.m. and then we'll do 4 p.m. on the next day. So in the breaks column, I log for my clients the amount of time that I was on breaks. If you need to do a start and end time, then just simply copy these over and you could do a start time for your breaks and end time for your breaks. But I'm just going to log the total time that I was on break. So we'll right click, format cells, and under time, I'm just going to choose one of the formats that doesn't have a PM designation next to it. So I'm just going to click on this 1330, and we'll say on the 8th, we'll say that I took a 30-minute break, and we'll do 1 hour on the 9th. So then to calculate the total hours, we'll just type equals, open parentheses, and your end time minus your start time minus the amount of time you took for breaks, close your parentheses, and then multiply that by 24, and then we'll just copy this for the next day. So a couple of things in the total hours is, first, make sure that it's formatted either general or as a number, ideally with 1 to 2 decimal points. So if you have like here 8.5 hours, you can see the 0.5. And then also, just FYI, the reason you multiply by 24 is just to normalize it back to a regular number. Because if we were to multiply it by 1, you see that all it did was calculate that 8.5 hours is 35% of a 24-hour day. So we need to multiply our total hours by 24. So now that we have our hours, the next thing we need to do is plug in our pay rate. So just an arbitrary number, we'll say $30. And we'll make this a currency. And then the total pay will just be your total hours times the pay rate. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful to learn how to track hours worked using Excel and how to calculate pay in Excel. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.